morning. Well, now a survival story at the Indianapolis Zoo that you just have to see. The main character goes on display tomorrow, but tonight, The Night Beat's Emily Longnecker gives you a preview, a story you'll see only on 13. Emily?
Yeah, John, the main character of that story is probably the first animal you're going to see when you head through the gates here at the Indianapolis Zoo. And look, if you don't see him, chances are you're probably going to hear him.
He's only been at the Indianapolis Zoo a month, but now that everyone can see him, Ray the sea lion has a lot to say.
And it's just who he is.
The people who know Ray's story would like to think he's voicing his appreciation after where he's been.
I think it's a combination. He's thrilled to be here and just that I'm here and I want everybody to know it.
He follows everybody. He's kind of like, hey, here I am. Come look at me. So he's definitely happy.
And who can blame him? At just 5 years old, Ray's been through a lot. He was rescued twice after beaching himself to die near Sausalito, California. Each time, Ray's rescuers discovered he'd been shot, probably by fishermen. The second time, Ray ultimately lost his right eye.
Just like a person who, you know, has a disadvantage, he'll compensate.
His trainers say he already is.
The exhibit has some underwater caves that he has to swim through. He's navigated all those fine. He gets up on the ground really well. He's doing good.
Ray's got a lot to look forward to. He's one of the zoo's most eligible bachelors. And the next step for the folks here is to find him a female to mate with next July.
We'll get him a girlfriend or two, and then we'll have some little sea lions swimming around.
Some little rays.
Yeah.
Jokes aside, the zoo says Ray's quite a specimen because of where he comes from.
His genetics are from the wild, so that means he's very valuable in that respect. So finding a good, suitable girlfriend would be a good thing.
For now, though, Ray's just getting used to his new home, his new roommates, and his new fans.
Yeah, and Ray seems to be getting along quite nicely with his new roommates, all of them females. The trainers here say the gals don't mind Ray. He seems to be fitting in quite nicely. Emily Longnecker, Channel 13 Eyewitness News.
All right, thanks, Emily. And Ray is not even full grown yet. When he is, he'll be between 600 and 800 pounds. Well, tonight we have a look behind.